Okay, I'm back. I have added a few extra features and changed the design a little bit further since the last video, and I just wanted to recap on those changes. The main thing is I noticed when I started to export the files that there was a slight variation in what should have been twin parts, in particular these two, the Y left and Y right plates. So what I decided to do was to delete one of the plates that I designed and then use the mirror tool here to actually create a identical plate on the opposite sides. So if I can click on this, will it let me go to edit profile sketch. You can see I've drawn a line along here. With the mirror tool, you select your object, in this case it's the sketches, and then you define the mirror line, and then you create an opposite piece. I've done that with the base plates, the sections with the motors and their opposite ends, and I've also done it with the Y plates. I've actually changed the Y plates a little bit as well. I've made them more squat, so I've pushed this section here forward by about 15 to 20 millimeters. And the reason I've done that is because I noticed that initially, when the gantry was brought forward, the center of the spindle was set quite far in, and this way I can actually cut closer to the edge here. So I'm actually slightly changing the geometry of the cutting area. I inset the openings for the mini V wheels along the C beam by about 5 millimeters. Initially they were quite close to the edge and I had a bit of problem with the locking collar on the Acme threaded rod actually hitting onto those Delrin wheels. So by moving that in a bit, I should be able to also again increase the movement between the two sides of this C beam. This should mean I have a larger wasteboard and cutting area. The height is the same. Like I said, this area here has been moved forward, just so the center of the spindle ends with the edge of the wasteboard. I can line the wasteboard up right to the edge. I think that will just look a bit neater. And the main thing I've done as well is added a notch here. So I've changed what was a opening here for the proximity cable to a notch, and what this is going to allow me to do is when I'm rebuilding my CNC machine, I'll be able to take the proximity sensor off, albeit cutting a little bit of material off the old wooden plates, and then fitting them without having to do any resoldering. So this is mainly just to make my life easier when I rebuild this machine. Yeah, so that's the main development. So the plates that are going to be available will not be the ones from the previous video in their entirety. You're going to have these, which are mirrored and therefore are more consistent. Because even with all the constraints, for some reason, somewhere along the way, I've added an error, especially between these two plates. I think these ones were fine on this side here, and I just couldn't identify where I'd done that. And it just makes sense to have these identical, because it means, depending on how you plan to set up your machine, you can have the motor on either side, therefore the drag chain and exit cables going towards a controller where it's better suited for the area that you're working in. So there's a bit more flexibility with how the machine can be assembled. There was something else. And what was it? Oh yes, I've added some feet onto these plates. So cutting across here, I can't remember how deep I did it, maybe about eight mil. So you can see that protrudes down, and that acts as a foot to raise the machine up, so the base Y support doesn't drag along the table. At the moment I've just got a couple of bits of wood under there on the prototype machine. Oh yes, there's one more thing. So just to support the drag chain along here, because these two plates on the Y are identical, you could attach a piece of aluminium angle bar along here. Simply just drill a couple holes on these plates here, even a single hole might be enough. Tap and bolt that on, and then the drag chain can rest against that, and you don't have the risk of it possibly falling into material. It's not a problem of a machine this size, but if you were going to make one larger, it would probably be a problem. For the top piece here, I'm just going to stick with the kind of aluminium method that I used on the prototype. I think that is affordable and it works, so I don't think I need to redesign that. Although, you know, I probably could add a bar coming out from this plate here to line up with potentially where that would go, but it adds an extra element there that might not be needed. I'm not sure. You know, you're talking about something potentially coming out quite some distance. I'll have a think about that. Maybe I'll incorporate that in a swing off version and just have that as an alternative plate. If you want an advanced copy of these plates, they are available on my Patreon page. The link will be in the description. Anyway, thanks again for watching.